We want to factor and solve quadratic equations in the form a squared minus b squared equals 0, which means when we have a difference of squares. Let's review how we factor this first. If we have a binomial in the form of a squared minus b squared, this will factor into two binomial factors, where one binomial factor will be a plus b, and one factor will be a minus b. So if we take a look at our first example, we have 48x squared minus 75. Notice 48x squared and 75 are not perfect squares, and therefore, we may think this won't factor, but we're forgetting the first step in factoring. The first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor. And both of these terms do have a common factor of 3. 48x squared can be written as 3 times 16x squared, and 75 can be written as 3 times 25. So the first step in this problem is to factor out the greatest common factor of 3. If we do this, we'll have 3 times the quantity 16x squared minus 25 is equal to 0. And now notice our binomial factor is a difference of squares. 16x squared is a perfect square because it's equal to 4x raised to the second power. 25 is a perfect square because it's equal to 5 squared. Written in this form, we can see a is equal to 4x and b is equal to 5. So now we can factor this again. We would have 3 times 2 binomial factors equals 0, where one binomial factor would be 4x plus 5, and one binomial factor would be 4x minus 5. Notice how we have a product now that's equal to 0. Therefore, by using the zero product property, the factor of 4x plus 5 must equal 0, or the factor of 4x minus 5 must equal 0. Notice the factor of 3 does not contain a variable, and therefore will not give us a solution to this equation. And now the last step is to solve these two equations for x. So for this first equation, we'll start by subtracting 5 on both sides. This will give us 4x equals negative 5. Divide both sides by 4. So we have x equals negative 5/4. And now we'll solve the second equation for x. So we'll add 5 to both sides. So we have 4x equals 5. Divide both sides by 4. And we have x equals positive 5/4. So these would be the two solutions to our quadratic equation. And I should also mention we could write the solution as x equals plus or minus 5/4. This is a short way to represent both positive 5/4 and negative 5/4. Looking at our second example, if we want to solve this equation by factoring, the first step is to set the equation equal to 0. So we'll start by subtracting 32 on both sides of the equation. On the left side, we'd have 2x squared minus 32 equals 32 minus 32 is 0. And then again, in this form, it doesn't look like we have a difference of squares. But again, the first step is to factor out the greatest common factor, which in this case would be 2. If we factor out 2, we'd have 2 times the quantity x squared minus 16 equals 0. X squared's a perfect square, 16's a perfect square, and we have a difference. So this does factor as a difference of squares. X times x is equal to x squared, so we have an x here and an x here. And 4 times 4 is equal to 16, so we have plus 4 and minus 4. And now because this product is equal to 0, either x plus 4 must equal 0 or x minus 4 must equal 0. Solving this equation for x, we would subtract 4 on both sides. So we have x equals negative 4, or here we would add 4 to both sides. We'd have x equals positive 4. So here are our two solutions, which again, if we wanted to, we could express as x equals plus or minus 4. So the most important thing to remember here is the first step in factoring is always to factor out the greatest common factor.